Sometimes science is hands-on. Really hands-on. Hey everyone, Julian here for DNews. Rule 35 is, if it exists, there's a scientist studying it. Rocks, got it. Space, you bet. Rocks in space, oh yeah, someone's all over that. But sometimes, in the quest to seek out knowledge wherever it may be hiding, scientists have to get their hands dirty and sticky. Sometimes they have to spank the monkey. Literally. It's not just done for enjoyment, although I'm sure the monkey doesn't mind. How orgasms fit into our evolution is still a bit of a question mark. What purpose do they serve? Male orgasms are usually tied to a release of sperm, so if ejaculating feels good in the short term, then it's more likely to breed more offspring long term. That makes sense. But females can have offspring with or without a climax, so why do they happen? Explanations vary. Maybe the sensation is enjoyable enough that seeking it out is worth the risk of copulating, which leaves you a bit exposed to predators in the wild. Or since humans start out developing the same in the womb, the same structure that becomes the penis in men is the clitoris in women. So maybe it's just vestigial. If that's the case, is it only other primates that have male and female orgasms? Did it start with mammals 65 million years ago? Or are there other animals that can experience it too? These are the questions scientists aim to answer with their hands-on experiments. Like in a 1981 Institute of Primate Studies study, where psychologist William Lemon and his grad student bring female chimps to orgasm by hand, or at least what they think was an orgasm based on the muscle contractions and facial expressions. Of course, they couldn't just ask the chimp directly if it orgasmed. So it's possible it faked it so it wouldn't hurt his feelings. Either way, I think we can all agree no one has done more to earn a master's degree than those students. They even reported that the chimps climaxed on 10 separate occasions, which, okay, now they're just showing off. But even though it may sound silly, these experiments demonstrated that yes, other female primates can orgasm too, and the female orgasm might be an evolutionary advantage we picked up from a distant relative. Other times scientists stimulate animals because they just want to know what's up with animal sex. Like Patricia Brennan of Yale University, who wanted to know how ducks got down. Most birds mate by pressing their rear ends together and exchanging fluids. It takes a couple seconds. Not ducks. Ducks have crazy corkscrew penises that they shoot out of their body. Female ducks have vaginas that can corkscrew in the opposite direction. To see how that affected mating, Brennan waited until a male was just about to mount a female, then quack-jacked him, swapping the female for one of four oddly shaped tubes. She found that certain shapes were much harder for males to enter. She noted that a female that actually wants to mate with a male can relax and position itself to be more receptive, but otherwise, she can make it more difficult to copulate, avoiding unwanted fertilization. Ducks are among the 3% of bird species that have penises, and one species, the red-billed buffalo weaver, actually has a false penis that serves no reproductive purpose. It has no sperm duct and doesn't become erect. Yet, females seem to prefer males with larger fake phalluses, and when it's stimulated, the males do seem to achieve orgasm. How do scientists know this? Because they did it themselves. Why it works, they don't know. More research is needed. Science isn't all microscopes and behavioral observations. Sometimes, to further scientific studies, we have to look closely at what we may see as taboo. But remember, sex, orgasms, and semen, it's all part of life. And understanding them will help us understand us. Scientists aren't just interested in the orgasms, though. They also study sperm. And they found some little swimmers that really went freestyle. Lacey and Alex break it down here.
This fossilized sperm is the oldest and longest that's ever been found. This monster sperm coils up into a ball, which scientists believe are tossed all crumpled up to the female, like they're playing catch or something.
Will it be you who boldly goes where no human man has gone before, or would you rather not watch how they do it on the Discovery Channel? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.